Chapter healing. Energy healing has always been around. In the old days, the healing was done by shamans, priests, medicine women, medicine men, and medicine men. For thousands of years, there was a separation between the official medicine and the alternative medicine. Even in the ancient kingdoms, there were doctors approved by the state, and there were shamans who were persecuted. So for thousands of years, the alternative medicine was a secret art practiced by the initiates and hidden from the public. This has changed when the arts of yoga and the art of Reiki has been released to the West in the 20th century. The modern materialistic medicine has good diagnostics to find a tumor and surgery to cut it out. Good diagnostics to find what is broken and then surgery to fix it. There is also good diagnostics to find the biochemical disorder and then the pharmaceutical drugs are used to fix the biochemical problem. The modern medicine achieved pretty good results in certain areas, but it still fails in many other areas. One of the major problems of modern materialistic medicine is that the pharmaceuticals help wonderfully in short term, but when they use chronically, they poison the body and cause death from side effects, and sickness and death from side effects. Another problem is that the problems of the soul, psychiatric problems, are helped by the pharmaceuticals very poorly. Many of psychiatric drugs are addictive, and many of the psychiatric drugs help only short term without solving the problem long term. Another area where the medicine is failing is working with inflammation. Chronic inflammation is not can be wonderfully treated short term, but in the long term, there is no good solutions. The alternative medicine approaches this problem very differently. Approaches these problems very differently. There is a general understanding that the soul is the primary, eternal cause, and the body is just a manifestation of the soul. There is a belief, an understanding that the many chronic sicknesses, many chronic disorders start from the problems of the soul, then they manifest in the body. For example, tumors and inflammation first all start from the psychological trauma, then they manifest as a psychosomatic pains. And when the pains continue and the problem of the soul is not solved, only then the pains manifest as inflammation or tumor. So the energy medicine believes that fixing the problems on the soul and energetic level could prevent and heal some of the chronic problems. There are sicknesses which are treated better by energy medicine, and there are sicknesses that are treated better by material medicine. For example, most of modern energy healers still go to dentists and use their help to treat the teeth because this is the area where the material medicine is better. Also, in the modern society, some bacterial infections are really hard to treat with energy medicine, so antibiotics sometimes are to be used. Are used even by energy healers to treat bad infection. So it takes discernment to figure out which disorders are better treated with energy medicine and which disorders are better treated with material medicine. Disclaimer, this opinion is considered a heresy by the official standpoint. Take it with discernment. The energy healing is best understood, best popularized by the energy healing is best known by the art of yoga and Reiki. The art of yoga uses exercises to normalize the energy flow in the body and prevent sicknesses. In yoga, you learn the exercises from the instructor and then heal yourself. While in yoga, the healing is applied to self, in Reiki, healing is applied to self and others. Yoga comes from India and Reiki comes from Japan. Yet these arts use the same roots, have the same roots, and use similar concepts. Both arts were secret until they were released to the West. Reiki is based on Qigong, which came from China, and to China it came from India, making this path in thousands of years. What in yoga is called prana, the healing energy. In Qigong in China it's called Qi, and in Reiki in Japan it's called Ki. So Reiki means healing energy. In addition to Reiki and yoga, there are many other forms of energy healing now in the West. Popular are Qigong, Tai Chi, Ayurveda, aromatic oils, essential oil, healing touch, EFT, hypnotherapy, Thai body work, THAI body work, shamanic healing, and many other forms of healing, of energy healing, which often use similar concepts and principles. The main understanding is that the health requires a healthy flow of spiritual energy. In addition to the material energy of the body, there is a non-material, non-physical flow of spiritual energy. This spiritual energy is called Qi, Ki, or Prana. It flows through the body and energizes it and coordinates its work. The physical health problems result from the distortions in energy flow. The energy flows through the body in many directions and dimensions. The main flow is from top to bottom and from bottom to top. There are also transdimensional vortexes of energy which are called chakras. The central chakra is the heart chakra. That vortex goes from the heart forward and from the heart backward. There are three major chakras below the heart chakra, and the lowest of them is the root chakra, which is corresponds to the place of the end of the spine. Above the heart chakra, there are three major chakras, the top one, which is it corresponds to the top of the head. Each of the chakras governs certain body functions and also certain spiritual functions and certain social functions of the person. They also connect the person to certain dimensions. Each chakra is characterized by a certain color and frequency. The root chakra is characterized by the red color and the lowest frequency. And the top chakra, called crown chakra, is characterized by the highest frequency and violet color. This has physiological reasons. The brain and spine consist of nerves which conduct the electrical impulses. So the distance between the brain and the end of the spine is the longest. So the oscillations, the electrical oscillations coming from the brain to the end of the spine and back take the longest time. That's why the frequency of the root chakra is the lowest. So the frequency of each chakra roughly corresponds to the distance between the head and the corresponding vertebrae. Although the electric oscillations are physical, they resonate with the spiritual frequencies which are non-physical and cannot be measured by the modern devices. Yet humans as conscious beings can connect to these oscillations on the soul level and do the healing work on the soul level. So the energy medicine, energy healing cannot be separated from the idea of spirituality. And by the nature is non-material, non-physical, and operates on the level of spirit and God. In the West, the energy healers enjoy much protection by the principle of freedom of religion. The energy healing is essentially a miracle which utilizes a spiritual work by the healer to remove the blockages and normalize the energy flows. And when energy flow is normalized, the pains go away, the inflammation often goes away, and the health returns. In Reiki, the healer uses the hands to move the energy and normalize the energy flow. In yoga, you use exercises and move your own body to help the energy flow, and much emphasis is on breath work. In EFT, there is a combination of simple physical activity and repeated healing affirmations. In addition to healing which can be rationalized, there are healings which result of simple miracle. Miracles happen, and they are well documented in many spiritual books. Although the reality often seems dark and hopeless, there are miracles in it. Many people, almost everyone, many times in their lives come to the moment when they should have died, but they are miraculously saved. In some of these cases, people experience near-death experiences, and they become aware of the miraculous work of the angel. The angels often intervene, saving people from death. It often happens that the person actually dies, but then the angels would come and replay this scenario to create a miraculous recovery. So the person might even remember dying, but then he would discover himself miraculously saved. This is one of the best proofs that reality is not real, that it is just a sophisticated simulation. The miraculous healings and miraculous recoveries from death are best examples of that. So why some people survive the accidents and sicknesses and some people die prematurely? Much depends on the desire of the soul, and much depends on the plan for the life. Sometimes an unexpected death is the best exit, which actually brings the most positive outcome for the other people. It is decided not from human perspective, not from human perspective at that moment, but from the bigger historical perspective. The decision is made by the spirits and the angel from the point of view of the development of the whole system. Thus, for example, the wars are permitted if they don't lead to the complete destruction of the species. One of the examples when the death was permitted was the death of John Kennedy. If you study his biography carefully, you will discover that by the time of death, his plan was almost finished. He was very sick and was on strong painkillers and psychoactive drugs. His death actually didn't stop the reforms, and many needed democratic reforms were completed after his death. At the same time, his violent death served a strong positive lesson to the humanity and serves to awakening of people even more than if he would have continued to live longer. A similar analysis might be applied to some other premature deaths of famous celebrities, such as John Lennon and Marilyn Monroe. Keep in mind that it is also a choice of the soul. Sometimes it could be beneficial for the soul to change the body, to incarnate in a better body than it was before. So the soul might step away from the life, incorporate the experience, integrate the experience, and then incarnate in a better circumstances to achieve a better result. What is tragic here on Earth in real time, in this time, could be acceptable from the higher perspective. The groups of wise spirits and elemental entities are responsible for keeping the life on Earth the way it is. Wise spiritual entities are responsible for bringing sickness to the humans, and wise entities are responsible for bringing death and making the life as short as it is. It is an artificial simulation. It is unique in the galaxy, and it is valued in the galaxy because it allows much spiritual progress in a short period of time. Many spirits from outside the Earth, from other planets in the galaxy, would like to experience the life on Earth, and many do incarnate on Earth. If the spirit comes from another planet and has no Earth experience, their life usually is short, since they have trouble surviving on Earth. The life on Earth requires special skills, so it takes several incarnations to get used to the life on Earth. So the spirits that come here from other planets usually are not adapted for life here, and they seem like they are not from this planet. And they often die prematurely. It is the price they pay for experience the life on Earth. In addition, there are teachers who are usually called Ascended Masters. These are the souls which had many incarnations on Earth, achieved high level of spiritual development, achieved high power of their spirit, and earned the right to move up to the next levels of creation. But they remain on Earth and incarnate again to bring their power and use their power to transform, help the Earth transform in a positive direction. Jesus, Buddha, and Confucius are among the Ascended Masters. The end of chapter healing. Chapter meditation. Meditation is an essential tool for self-healing and spiritual growth. The modern materialistic society offers you many artificial goals. Money, sex, power, popularity, career, possessions, sensual pleasures. You are supposed to look a certain way, behave a certain way, be interested in certain things, enjoy certain things. Yet when you become old, you discover that all of that has no value. From the spiritual perspective, the main value, the main goal is spiritual growth. It is the purity of the spirit, the power of the spirit, the integrity of the spirit that matters. All material goals are temporary and illusionary. They are nice tools and prompts for the spiritual growth, but their value is secondary. As you get experienced and mature, you discover that the main answers are inside. The life is given to you not to achieve something outside, but mainly to achieve something inside. So your inner life is of primary importance. Many modern people are trapped in their daily routine and external pleasures. They look for external approval of other people. They are busy working during the day and busy entertaining and relaxing after and socializing when they don't work. And they forget about inner life. So when they become old and stop working and lose friends, they just discover that their inner life is underdeveloped. So it is very important as you grow and develop to pay attention to your inner life. And meditation is one of the best tools to face inward and work on your inner life. In meditation, you disconnect from the outer world and focus inside. For some people, it is difficult to look inside because they would find there much of hidden fear, anger, and grief, and pain. So processing these negative things is one of the goals of meditation. Another goal is to connect to your spirit, and through your spirit to connect to God directly. So in essence, a meditation is a phone line to God. During the meditation, you upload to the creation all your pains and troubles and download health and answers. Keep in mind that your physical health and the health of your soul are tightly linked. The physical illness which results from the psychological trauma is called psychosomatic. In chronic illnesses, the psychological trauma, pain and inflammation often go together. It is the case for arthritis, for the allergies, for heart problems, and many other neurological and skin problems. neurological, digestive and skin problems. The biological system responsible for the inflammation is called immune system. One of its functions is to hunt infections. Another function is to keep cancer under control and to constantly eliminate any cells that convert to cancer. And when the immune system becomes dysregulated, it causes chronic inflammation. In almost all chronic pain diseases, there is a combination of pain, which is overexcitation of nerves, and inflammation. And this is a self-activating, self-reinforcing circle, self-reinforcing cycle, where active nerves activate, overly active neurons activate the inflammatory response, and the inflammatory response closes the cycle by activating nerves. So they activate inflammation and nerves activate each other. Even the mainstream science recognizes now the connection between the psychological trauma, the activation of the nerves, and the inflammation. The mainstream science recognizes that stress contributes to arthritis, skin inflammation, and cancer. The psychological trauma is a trauma of the soul. Psyche is the soul in Greek. What is not understood by the mainstream science is the involvement of spiritual energy. The trauma of the soul is converted to the disease, not only chemically, but also through spiritual energy mechanisms. The trauma of the soul produces a negative energy, produces a negative program, self-destructive program, which becomes selfish and disconnected from the flow of the energies in the body. The negative energies block the flows and create negative vortexes of energy. These negative vortexes of energy are connected to certain cells through the cellular vibrations, through cellular electromagnetic vibrations, specifically through the vibrations of proteins and DNA. And these negative vortexes program the cells to behave selfishly, in disharmony, without harmony with the rest of the body. These selfish cells can induce cancer or inflammation or pain. Energy healing and meditation are among best tools which help healing these negative energies, removing the blockages and removing the negative vortex. One of the main goals of the meditation is reconnecting of the mind and the soul. It is the inner work which integrates and integrates different parts of the mind and the subconscious. In the meditation, the traumatic experience is uploaded to the spirit, and it becomes the part of the accumulated collective spiritual knowledge, and the healing is downloaded from the spirit and improves the health and improves your health. The efficiency of meditation for reducing the stress, reducing pain and inflammation is even absorbed by the mainstream medicine and accepted by the mainstream medicine. The nature of modern human life is very unnatural. The stress of the modern life is very artificial. The majority of living beings in the nature are not stressed out. Look at the cats, look at the dogs. They are constant reminders that the life is possible without stress. Yet modern civilization developed many ways to stress out a human. For many, becoming stressed out becomes a habit. People become workaholics and worry much of the time. Even when people have free time and are supposed to rest, they still find ways to become stressed out. Many watch television, many watch stressful movies, read stressful news, and get hooked, get addicted to stressful information and activity. Meditative state is very natural. It brings you back to the natural balance. Many human, traditional human occupations are balanced and non-stressful. Gardening, cooking, and washing dishes are among those occupations which bring you back to the balance, if you allow yourself to relax. These kinds of work could be one of the ways to meditate. There are many ways to meditate. They might look different, but the result is essentially the same. They bring you back to balance, and they bring you back to yourself, and they reconnect you with the spirit. Here I will describe a very basic meditation available to anyone. First, you need to find the time to meditate. Some people have plenty of free time and some people have no time. And those who have no time usually are most stressed out. So the shortest meditation would be like 15 minutes once a day. Most optimal timing for an active person would be 3 times a day, 40 minutes each. The times for meditations can be subtracted from your sleeping time. This way you would still have time to work, but you will become healthier and more balanced and less stressed. If you are working usual work hours, you can fit one meditation during the lunch, one meditation after you come from work, and one meditation when you go to sleep. There are many people who meditate much longer. This would be people who are sick and are working on healing themselves. There would be yogis, spiritual workers, creative people, retired people, people who really focus on their spiritual development. It's not unusual to meditate 10 to 15 hours a day. Next, it is important to find a quiet, protected place for the meditation. In an ideal situation, you would go to your room, put a sign on your door, don't disturb, and lay on your bed. Many people use their car for meditation during a lunch break. Meditating in the nature is wonderful. As you are a beginner, it's important to avoid distractions, but as you become used to meditate, then the distractions don't bother you anymore. You can easily either ignore them or get out of meditation, solve the problem, and come back to meditation again. Find a position for the meditation which is best for you, which produces best results. Lying down has the advantage that you can completely and easily get disconnected and not being worried about your body at all. It is better to lie on your back straight in the most comfortable position with a pillow and sometimes using a blanket, so you get as little distractions as possible. The straight position is has the advantage that your body becomes a better antenna and is a more symmetrical resonator, so it can connect to the spirit in a better way. But lying on your stomach or your side is also acceptable, whatever is easier for you. Some people don't like to meditate in the horizontal position because they just simply get asleep, especially if they are tired. So instead of meditation, you just sleep. Merging your meditation with a nap is a good idea. Dalai Lama said sleep is best meditation. In the sleep, you also upload the experiences to the spirit and download the health. The difference is that in meditation, you use your intention to connect to the spirit. You guide yourself in the process and you bring back from the meditation the specific results. Sitting in lotus position, many people practice meditation by sitting in lotus position or sitting on a chair in Western position. The advantage is that your spine is straight and vertical and is this way is in balance and is connected to the earth energies in a different way. Also, meditating in a sitting position prevents you from falling asleep. Meditation while standing, walking, doing repetitive work is also possible. It doesn't allow you as deep penetration into the spirit. It doesn't allow to disconnect from the body completely, but the repetitive motion has its own virtues and benefits. You know better if you need to be in a quiet place to meditate. Some people are very sensitive to sounds, and some people can disconnect very easily. As you become more balanced and more guided by the spirit, you will find yourself more protected, and this way you don't have to be all the time on the guard, so you can easier to disconnect and trust that you will be protected. In the beginning, it is important to find a quiet place. It is also a good idea to use earmuffs. Such earmuffs you can buy in a hardware store for woodworkers or on Amazon. Using the meditation music is also a good idea. Very often the music would prevent you from going too deep or from sleeping, but it creates a certain vibration which in the beginning helps you to disconnect from the reality, and also it blocks the noises. So using headphones with the music allows you to become less distracted and to focus on the meditation. Many guided meditations are available on YouTube. A guided meditation is a good beginning. It gives you certain vibrations, certain tuning, but as you practice, you might find that meditating in the silence allows you to get into meditative state faster and be more connected to your own experiences and your own soul rather than being guided by someone else. As you select the meditation on YouTube, try many ones and see which ones sound better for you and which ones give you better sense of trust, better sense of protection, and better resonates with you. You can convert your YouTube guided meditation to a sound file, MP3 file, download on your phone, and be ready to meditate anytime using headphones. Just don't forget to put your phone in their airplane mode, so to disconnect the ringers and notifications. Another option is to use the application called Mute Ringer, which would allow you to mute ringer only for the meditation time, and it will reactivate automatically when you are done. It is very healthy to meditate in a place with good energies and fresh air. As you become sensitive to energies, you will feel which energies are best for you. Such places could be the top of the hill, seashore, a bank of a river, a place near a little creek, any place with a natural water. A forest is a great place. Artificial places like churches, domes, and pyramids are great. Yet some other places are pretty negative. So when places are charged with negative energy and connected with the suffering, you might want to build a walled, imaginary wall around you to protect yourself from the negative energies. You start the meditation by finding a comfortable position, adjusting your pillow and blanket, adjusting the earmuffs. Also, sleeping mask for your eyes would allow you to go into darkness and also helps to focus on the meditation. Relax the palms and put them on your stomach in the most comfortable position. You can put your relaxed right palm on the solar plexus and the left palm on your navel area. Adjust these positions to feel most comfortable. then focus on your breathing and intend to breathe slower and deeper than usual. Use your belly to breathe in and out, so your belly moves more than usual. Choose an intention for today's meditation. The most standard intention, as I said, would be to upload your troubles to the spirit, get back the healing and the answers. If you have the questions to the spirit, pronounce them for yourself and expect to have some resolution by the end of the meditation. That resolution doesn't have to come in words. It could be just better understanding, better peace with a question. It is a good idea to say a short prayer. In each meditation, you might address a specific, you might want to address a specific aspect of the God or the Spirit. You can address your prayer to the one God, to the Creator, to the Divine Mother, to the universe, to the Source, to the energy of the Source, to Yeshua, Jesus, angels, archangels, a specific angel, specific archangel, a specific friendly alien, specific ancestor of yours, a dead relative, a spirit of your favorite celebrity. On different days you may be attracted to different consciousnesses, so do it as you feel better. Keep in mind from a certain perspective, they all become one, they are all united in the spirit. They all are aspects of God's, of God as you are. A typical prayer starts with a gratitude, continues with the invitation to help, and ends with a gratitude. Here is an example of a typical short prayer. Thank you, the universe, for this experience. I invite your healing energy, and I thank you for sending me the healing. The time from the spiritual perspective is much more fluid, so it is okay to thank for the healing which will come later in your time. And the gratitude is one of the best remedies from stress. The gratitude doesn't only, not only heals the trauma, it also helps you in your luck and in your work and in your daily life. Meditation continued. So you found the time for meditation, you found the space, you're comfortable, you blocked your eyes. So you're in the dark, you blocked your ears, you're in the quiet. You started breathing. Are you actually meditating? How do you know that you're doing the right thing? What do you actually do during the meditation? All what has been said so far is physical. Anyone can do it, but the next step is spiritual. You can program a robot to lie down, to close the eyes, to close the ears, and to breathe deeply, but the robot possibly won't be able to meditate. But a spiritual being like you can meditate. So what is the secret? The secret is to make a transdimensional jump. Until now, all the actions are physical and can be actually described in words. But as you do such a transdimensional jump, what you feel there, what you see there, often cannot be described by words and is not a subject to understanding of physical mind. So as the next step, you need to shift from the physicality, from the understanding of physical sensations, from feeling yourself, from the senses, to the area where you don't feel, you don't sense, where your consciousness exists, but you lose the connection to the physical world. So we are asking for a miracle, and this miracle is actually accessible to anyone. Some people disconnect from the physical world with ease. For others, it is a skill which needs to be developed. What makes it much easier is the understanding that you are not alone, that you are being helped by the spirit on the other side. you are being guided. A desire to meditate, a desire to shift to a higher reality is sufficient. If you get in a quiet place, if you quiet your mind, you will be helped to shift. Another thing that helps, another understanding that helps to meditate, is to understand that meditation is essentially a form of a sleep. It is a sleep with intention. It is a dream with intention. It is a dream with intention. Dalai Lama said sleep is best meditation. What makes meditation is much easier is to understand that you go to the other side every night when you sleep. All you need to do now is to go on the other side with intention, with the intention to connect to the spirit, to upload your worries, to download your health, to balance your energy, and to assist your spiritual growth. Brain imaging studies and brain wave measurements show that in the meditation you reach the same brain waves as you do in a dream, in a sleep. Only because you do it with intention and consciously, you can achieve a higher harmony, higher coherence, and better connection, better communication to the spirit. When people meditate, they usually go to a higher vibration, to a happier place, to better balance and better healing. But there are few people who drift to darkness. There are some people, those people are so stressed out and are so prone to depression, habitually prone to depression, that when they meditate, they habitually go into sadness and connect to the lower vibrations. So the meditation for them can become a bad trip. If you meet this trouble, look for help from someone who can guide you to the higher vibration. It can be guidance in person or a guidance through YouTube video or through books or other ways. A great help with guiding to higher vibration is Reiki. Reiki is one of the ways of using Reiki is to guide the meditation to high vibration. A Reiki session can become an assisted meditation. So getting Reiki and learning this vibration of high connectedness could be a solution for those of you who can who tend to be depressed and stressed out even during the meditation. So during the Reiki session, a healer places hands on your head and another time on your heart and sends a spiritual energetic vibration to your head and heart and brings you up to a healing state of mind. Remember this state and then you would be able to reproduce it during your meditation and induce these brave waves which bring you to a higher, more balanced, more happier state of mind. As you shift in your meditation to another dimension, to another side, there are certain signs which help you to understand that you are doing the right thing, that you are moving in the right direction. As you invite a communication with your favorite spirit, favorite angel, favorite archangel, an aspect of God, expect it to come, and often it would come as light which you feel, which you see inside your head, not through your eyes. It is a spiritual vibration which creates a physical electric waves in your brain, in the visual cortex area of your brain. As you see that light, move towards it, embrace it, and realize you can make it stronger. It is in your power to go in that light and make it stronger. Same relates to other sensation which you might get, like the warmness in your heart, the healing light in your heart, the sensation in your head and heart. As you feel them, and if they're good, embrace them and make them stronger and move in that direction. In a good meditation, your body becomes disconnected from... In a good meditation, your attention becomes disconnected from your body. As you shift in a higher dimension, you lose the control over your body, and that feels like numbness. You cannot move your hands and legs. Welcome that. That is a sign of good meditation. Usually you still control your breathing. So enjoy breathing deeply and slowly in a comfortable manner, and just welcome the numbness and heaviness in your rest of your body. When you come back, don't worry about the numbness of your body. Slowly come back. Give your soul a time to reconnect to the body and to take control of the body. Usually it takes minutes to come back, and it is healthier to come back slowly. So first move your fingers and toes and give yourself time to reconnect. As you become reconnected automatically, it happens automatically, unconsciously, subconsciously, you would often feel an urge to wake up and move. So as you do, move slowly, don't rush. You would still have some leftovers of your dreams. So coming back to physical life usually takes a little bit of time and practice. As you come back, use that time to ask questions and get answers. Prepare your questions for the spirit in advance. And this time of coming back is a wonderful time when you're partly still connected to the spirit and partly already are in control of your mind. And this is a time when you can ask questions and get some intuitive answers. Don't expect to hear anything or see anything, but expect to feel the answer, to have a good feeling what the spirit recommends you. There are many good visualizations which help you to get in a meditation state. Many guided meditations would give you these visualizations. I would recommend to visualize that as you breathe the air in, you breathe in the energy of the universe, the healing energy of the universe. And as you breathe it out, pump it in your heart and visualize a ball of glowing energy in your heart, golden flame in your heart. So as you breathe in, you take the golden energy from the universe, and as you breathe out, pump it in your heart and grow a ball of golden healing light in your heart. And this is about it. There is not much more to do. It is going to the point where you are quiet and still, when you are disconnected from your worries and your body, and trust that the spirit will come and your focus of attention shifts to the area of higher vibration where it would dwell in the spirit. Release your worries there and bring back the answers, the healings, and the spiritual upgrades. Many people have hard time disconnecting from their thoughts and quieting down the worries. Realize it is only for the time of meditation that you have to quiet them down. So in the meditation, if the worry or a thought becomes excited in your mind, don't push it away. Be kind to it. Just talk to it and ask it to wait until you get out of meditation. So basically put it on the side burner. Put it on a shelf and say to it that you will think about it later. So you don't have to think about it during the meditation. You can delay that, delay. And clean your mind. There are nice visualizations for clearing up your mind. Take the one which is good for you. You can visualize washing dishes. You can visualize washing windows. I recommend to visualize a windshield wiper, which works and removes all the thoughts, all the images, all the concerns which pop up in your mind. Just wipe them out and have your mind clean and empty. It takes a lot of integration work, purification work, to really be able to disconnect from the physical reality and shift into the stillness. In your physical body, there are several points where you can still put your mind to rest. One of them is heart, so to focus the mind on your heart. Another point is in the middle of the head, in the area of the pineal gland, which is also called the third eye. And the third point is a third eye spot on the forehead, the place between the brows, which is usually colored by some Hindus with a red dot. So the spot on your forehead, you can focus your presence, your focus of attention on this spot on your forehead. It doesn't matter that much where you focus of your attention. It is what matters is that your mind gets to the stillness point, gets to the balance, and stops thinking about physical, about anything. If your meditation work right, then after the meditations you would get much more energy, much more health, and more amazingly the reality would be better and friendlier to you. Your problems would gradually resolve to your favor. Meditation is a miracle work, and the main miracle is that while you quiet your mind, there is something done in the background without your conscious intervention. Something is done subconsciously to help your physical life, help with your problems. As you come out of the meditation, repeat your prayers and thank your spiritual helpers for their help. If some of your meditations are not as deep as the others, don't worry, because the depth of meditation depends on many factors, and one of them is planetary alignment. Sometimes meditating is easy, and sometimes meditating is almost impossible. For the whole meditation you remain conscious, you don't shift on the other side, and you don't feel the numbness. All the attributes might be wrong, yet it does still help to meditate, even if it doesn't go fully, if you don't go fully into other side. Even a partial meditation still has lots of benefits for health and the spirit. For health, the spirit, and your practical life. Now, as you learned about an ideal meditation, or one of the ideal meditations, I realized that a good meditation often happens even without all its attributes. You might be on the run, you might not find a quiet place, you might not lay down in a comfortable position. Sometimes a good meditation might take a split second. It takes a split second to connect to the spirit and get help from there. So some humans and some people and some experienced meditators can meditate on the run. In ideal situation, you are constantly 100% of your time, 100% of your life are connected to the spirit and are in the balance. Consider dolphins. Dolphins are unique in a way that they always are awake and they always are asleep. Their brain is divided into two halves, of which one is awake and another is asleep. And these two halves take turns. So a dolphin is always conscious and always connected to the other side. So that is an ideal of a perpetual continuous meditator. You are always present here in physicality and are always present on the other side. Although this continuous meditation can be achieved only by special, ultra-pure, ultra-advanced spiritual people. If it doesn't come easy, consider doing more practical stuff to shift between the meditation state and the awakened state. So be like a swing, like a pendulum, shift to the meditation, be in the meditation state, then shift out and be in conscious state and connect to the physicality. This serves your practical needs and also it serves the spirit. In the physicality, you can go in any vibration you like. You can be down, you can be practical, you can be grounded, you can be working on the vibration of other people, you can connect to the other people on their level of understanding. And then you go back to your meditation and there you upload all your experience to the spirit and receive back the answers and the healing. So going back and forth is natural and you can do it at any time and get your results. It takes practice, it takes commitment, and also it takes connecting to other humans, other people who are teachers and helpers with meditation. Being in the presence of a teacher and a group of meditators really helps to get on the other level. Even the most experienced of the meditators still learn more when they connect to the other people. Everyone can be your teacher. Even people of lower development still can help you in your meditations and help you with raising to the new level. Subchapter, becoming an avatar. From the spiritual perspective, the purpose of life is to go through the lessons and get experience. It is not that the body has a soul, but it is the soul uses the body to obtain physical experience and uses the body to achieve spiritual growth. The purpose of your life on earth is not predetermined. You define the purpose of your life. You have a free choice and you can choose to serve the spirit in its desire to obtain the experience and to grow and to help the spirit to grow. Our individual spiritual growth is the main concern of our spiritual teachers. So it is a good idea for you to focus on your spiritual growth, but it is your choice. As you work on your meditations and as you work on your spiritual growth, it is your choice to invite your higher self into your body and to submit to the guidance of the spirit. It doesn't relieve you from solving practical questions in physical life, but it takes the weight of responsibility for the life direction from your physical mind to your higher self. And it plugs you as an agent into this work of the spirit on earth. You become a messenger and a worker of the spirit on earth. It can be called light worker and it can be called an avatar. An avatar is God incarnated on earth. So as you connect to the spirit and become the worker of God, then you become an avatar. It is your choice, it is an opportunity offered to you. As you start performing the work for the cosmic intelligence on earth, as you commit to this work, you will be given more energy, more assignments, and more tools for more help in completing this assignment. You will still learn your spiritual lessons and practical lessons, but in addition, you'll be plugged into a network of the light workers who work the work of the spirit and walk the path which is assigned by the higher spiritual intelligence. The choice is yours, and the meditation is one of the great tools towards that path. At the end of chapter meditation.